Across the developing world, many countries are still struggling to eradicate poverty and hunger, increase access to education, and promote gender equality. Hamstrung by a lack of public funding, institutions have had to rely on generosity and donations to prop up a creaking infrastructure. For many years, Sahara, an international energy and infrastructure company with operations in 38 countries across Europe, Asia, the Middle East, and Africa, has had a foundation to give back to the communities in which they operate. With a genuine commitment to sustainability, they operate various initiatives to close the gap on poverty, education, hunger, and gender equality. There is still, for example, an alarming difference in the numbers of girls and boys attending school across Africa, with 3 boys for every 1 girl in education. This is due to a number of reasons, from widespread poverty and entrenched gender stereotypes to child marriages, early pregnancies, and gender-based violence. The Vision of Hope Young Women's Home was established to house young girls that have fallen victim to domestic abuse and no longer have a home to go to. Sahara has donated a kitchen to the shelter in evidence of their commitment to gender equality.
Vision of Hope was founded in 2009. We are working with girls that are highly marginalized, that are vulnerable, they are homeless, and we provide a safe home and a few services such as education, skills training, and we also provide recreation. We want them to go out and interact. Of course, most of them are victims of trauma. So we try as much to create a safe place for them where they can just loosen up and get to know more about them. And they also learn about us. The age group is from 11 to about 18, 20. But you find that we have little ones. Today, the youngest is 10 months old. That is an indication that we are also housing girls that are victims of sexual assault. We let them live here with their baby. They grow up with their babies. But then during that time, this young mother is exposed to something, possibly going to school and coming back, find the baby, or participating in the craft skills training. Sahara came on board towards the end of 2016. They had to identify the gaps that as an organization we were experiencing. They identified to build the extension of the kitchen. You notice we had a small little kitchen. Looking at the number, because minimum we have 45 children in the facility. When you talk about cooking, they looked at some of the challenges because we're cooking out in the sun and they've put up a beautiful kitchen. And one of the things that we have learned from Sahara is that our support is quite self-sustainable.
It's nice to be here and to be among the girls who are found here. At least we get to have a chance to experience school. We get to be empowered. We get to know a lot of people, the way our country is supposed to be and how we are supposed to behave in the community. We learn different kinds of skills, how to make earrings, bags, different kinds of things. I love cooking. That's my passion. I have passion in that. And we thank the Sahara group for the kitchen that they've provided for us. Okay, I see my future to be a better one because I learn a lot of things. I can empower myself by the things we learn from the craft house. I can be a better citizen. Rather than sitting, I would find something to do and bring income at my own house.
In the last 20 years, Africa's reputation for quality of education has fallen to an all-time low. With parents needing children to stay at home to work, education budgets plummeting relative to the rest of the economy, and a significant gender gap. Another key factor driving the gender gap is the lack of accessibility to sanitary products, Many schools lack basic bathroom facilities, forcing girls to miss or leave school earlier than they should, which in turn is affecting their education. Once again, Sahara have been supporting the communities close to them. By donating a toilet block to Pugu Secondary School, they sought to bridge the gender gap by giving access to sanitary facilities that enable girls to stay in school and improve education and life chances in the process.
During the menstrual cycle, most of the girls are not coming to school because there is nowhere they can change their stuff. So no way, they have to stay at home. And the school will proceed while they're at home. They are not waiting for them. So you find in the performance, there is that gender gap in terms of performance, in terms of school attendance, in terms of girls' participation. But in the presence of this facility, I tell you, that gap has been reduced. So you find the class attendance has been increased, has been improved, but also the performance as well, because they are not missing. We are in partnership with Sahara Foundation, working on three areas: poverty alleviation, improving the quality of education, and improving the gender equality between girls and boys, women and men. To support the youth, we identified the talents that students have. From there, we found that the students that we are supporting have lots and very good, interesting talents. But if they are supported, they can move forward and go back to the sustainable development goal number one, poverty eradication. What we did is to identify those talents, and then we supported with the training, specific training, but also they did their own project.
I love to learn science. Science speaks a lot about our environment.
I wanna help my family and my relatives. I want to provide the same amount of education I get here from school. I want them to know it well. When I get that education, when they get education, we'll be one team, then we'll participate together on how to protect our environment.
They have to choose what they like to do, because what we want to help them is to unleash their potentials. So when it comes to vocational skills, they have to say what they like the most. And that's why we come up with people who like arts, fashion designing, electricity related stuff, things like that.
Good crops require educated farmers, and Sahara set up the Food Africa initiative in 2018 in order to provide ongoing training and education for farmers that will lead to less waste and reduce hunger. The project aims to impact 500,000 people directly by 2020, with many more benefiting indirectly from the improvement of agriculture standards and reduction of food waste.
Yes, I really improve. Because when I have seen that I went for the School of Agriculture just because of this Food Africa project, I came back, I start my farm. I was having before 1 hectare. I told my dad, okay, please dad, will you give me like 3 to 4 hectares? Let me just try something. So this is how we're supposed to pack our goods and to be selling them instead of them to be keeping them spoiled. Then actually they appreciate them to me. And then before, to keep their things inside the house anyhow, very, very important. You can make some of us, our children, can they affect. Because this Food African project also teaches us how to maintain ourselves and how to look very clean. Because so that anything we are doing, our people, when they're close to us, they'll be learn from us. And people today, they learn from me. Actually, I'm proud to be a farmer. Then and the farm today make me today grow. Anywhere I pass, I don't fear, because I know I'm a farm farmer, and I'm proud of it. I'm very happy with the Food African project.
The Sustainable Development Goals provide a viable template for organizations across the world to improve the lives of many, as well as taking care of our planet. With their commitment to ending hunger, improving education, and boosting gender equality, Sahara is a shining example of what can be done with that template, and they hope to continue to improve lives all over Africa and beyond for many years to come.